हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 895 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज द इंडस्ट्रियल मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ येलो पिगमेंट्स. देर आर सो कॉमनली नोन एज क्रोम येलो, दैट इज ब्राइट येलो इन कलर. नेचुरली द येलो पिगमेंट्स आर आइसोलेटेड फ्रॉम ओकरे अर्थ क्ले एंड इन अमेरिकन इंग्लिश इट इज कॉल्ड ओकर. एक्चुअली द वर्ड ओकर इज फ्रॉम ग्रीक, इट मीन्स पेल येलो एंड दिस क्ले इज पाउडर ग्राउंड एंड देन इट इज फिल्टर्ड स्क्रीन एंड द येलो पिगमेंट दैट इज 20-30% ferrous oxide, that is yellow pigment, is extracted out. Also the yellow pigment is industrially manufactured by treating lead nitrate either with sodium dichromate or sodium acetate, and in this process sodium dichromate or sodium acetate will be converted in presence of lead nitrate into chrome yellow, that is PbCrO4. So in this way yellow pigment is industrially manufactured. And nowadays some terms are used, they are known as toners, available in market. Actually the toners are nothing but they are insoluble organic dyes, and in different names they are sold and they are used as a source of pigment, colored pigment. And also now the metallic pigments are also available, and mainly these metallic pigments are either aluminium powder, bronze powder, zinc powder, and zinc powder is very common to galvanize the tin and to just coat all these aluminium, zinc or bronze powder in order to protect from rusting or atmospheric oxygen reaction. So here the industrial manufacture of yellow pigments, two methods are given. One is from natural clay and second one is the synthetic method. So here the industrial manufacture of yellow pigments, number one, ochre, and in English, I mean the American English, it is also known as ochre, is a natural earth clay pigment. It is naturally occurring yellow pigment with 10-30% lead hydroxide, that is ferric hydroxide. And these yellow pigments are suitable for paint industry. The natural yellow pigment is isolated by grinding it in presence of an oil of proper grade. The pigment particles are allowed to settle at the bottom of floating process, and fine particles are carried by the oil to a settling tanks where they are filtered, dried, screened and finally packed. Ochre is golden yellow in color, having moderate opacity and spreading power. It changes color from yellow to reddish when calcined. This is dehydration means removal of water molecule. It is due to the dehydration of ferric hydroxide. It resists corrosion action of light but cannot resist acid. Number two, that is industrial manufacture of chrome yellow. chrome yellow are most popular yellow pigments as they have great opticity, high brilliance, high hiding power and high tinting strength. They are industrially manufactured by mixing a solution of lead nitrate or lead acetate with a solution of sodium dichromate, and that is reaction is given here. 2 PbNO3 twice is your lead nitrate, and Na2Cr27 is your sodium dichromate, and after reaction we will get the product, that is 2 PbCrO4. 2 PbCrO4 is your chrome yellow pigment is formed, plus 2NaNO3 plus 2HNO3. The precipitation is carried out in wooden tanks provided with agitation. The precipitate of lead chromate is washed to remove soluble impurities, then filtered, pressed and dried at about 90 degree centigrade temperature, pulverized, and finally it is packed. So nowadays toners and metallic pigments are widely used, and these toners are nothing but they are insoluble organic dyes with different code names are available as a source of pigment. Number 3, toners. Toners are insoluble organic dyes and can be used as pigments. They are quite durable and have high coloring power. For example, they are available in the name of like Para Red, Hansa Yellow G. Hansa Yellow G is actually lemon yellow. Then Hansa Yellow 10G, that is Prime Rose Yellow. Then Toledine Toner, etc. And are the various dyes that have been used as toners in pigment industries. I have given some these toners preparation, how we can prepare. Just I have given the hint. A. How to prepare Para Red. It can be prepared by diazotization of P stands for para. You know, in benzene ring, if any substituent is there, after that substituent, the position of ring is determined as para, ortho and meta. So P stands for para, M stands for meta and O stands for ortho. So PMO is written here. So the Para Red, that's why it is also known as Para Red. Para Red, it can be prepared by diazotization of para nitro aniline and coupling it with beta naphthol. B. Hansa Yellow G. It can be prepared by diazotization of meta nitro para toledine and coupling with acetoesterolide. C. Hansa Yellow 10G. It is prepared by coupling the diazotized 4-chloro-2-nitro-aniline with ortho-chloro-acetanolide. D. Toledine toner. It is a red pigment and is prepared by coupling the diazotized meta-nitro-para-toledine with beta-naphthol. Number 4, metallic powder as pigments. Now it is very common, this metallic powder in the form of pigments. the powder form of metals as well as alloys have also been used as pigments. For example, powdered aluminium, powdered bronze have been used as pigments in lacquers. Pigments containing finely powdered zinc have been used for protective coating on iron and steel. That's why in countries, even in Nigeria, they call it zinc sheet. Zinc sheet means it is all this steel or iron or tin. They are coated with zinc to resist the atmospheric corrosion, used to protective coating on iron and steel to protect them from atmospheric corrosion. So with this, your pigment industry is over. That is manufacturing, industrial manufacture of pigments. Now I will be starting the industrial manufacture of paints. Actually, paints are the stable mixture of different pigments to get a different shade. So industrially, it is manufactured with different ratio. That is very interesting topic, and it has lot of potential, lot of economy, and in the world it is now $1 billion industry. With this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.